Morning, dear students. This is lesson 3, food and health. So in this chapter you will study about components of balanced diet. What are the components of balanced diet? What is balanced diet? Importance of eating a balanced diet. Then what is junk food? Meaning and examples of the junk food. Ways to make diet more healthy. Disease related to food habits, lifestyles, some common deficiency disease and ways to prevent them. Meaning and examples of food adulteration. So today, in today's video children, we will learn about the components of balanced diet, importance of eating a balanced diet and junk food. Remaining we will study in the next class. So let's see what is there. Food and health. So here children, for before knowing the chapter, you have to fill this chart. What you have to do there? What food did you eat yesterday? You have to tell me that what you had in breakfast, lunch and dinner yesterday in the timetable given below. Write the names of all the food items you eat. So you have to write the names of what all things you have taken yesterday in the breakfast, lunch and dinner in the provided blanks. Okay, so let's see the lesson. All of us want to be healthy. Being healthy means having a strong, disease-free body and alert mind. It means that we all want to be healthy. You also want to be healthy. I also want to be healthy. Nobody wants to be sick. And being healthy means having a strong, disease-free body. Healthy means that your body is disease-free. There is no disease in your body. You are free of disease. And alert mind. And your mind is also, if we are healthy, our mind is also healthy, children. So, for keeping our mind healthy, we have to keep our self healthy, our body healthy. When we are healthy, we can study well and take part in sports and other activities. If you are healthy, your mind also will be healthy. You can study well and you can take part in other activities also. Food plays an important role in keeping us healthy. If you are eating healthy foods, surely your health, you will be healthy. Eating food rich in various nutrients helps us to grow well. If you are eating food with the good nutrients, with different nutrients, help your body to grow well and stay healthy. So if you are eating the food rich with nutrients, your body will be healthy. Nutrients give us energy to study, work and play. So the nutrients which are present in our food, it gives us energy to study, work and play. That's why we say that take everyday milk. Okay, because milk has calcium, that is the nutrient. Okay, they help our body to grow. They also help our body to fight diseases and remain healthy. If people say that if we eat an apple, it keeps doctor away. Means after if we are taking every day one apple, it keeps you away from the disease. Okay, so they also help our body to fight diseases and to remain healthy. So if you are eating the food which are rich with the nutrients, it keeps your body healthy. And for keeping healthy body, what you have to do? Your body has to fight with diseases. The nutrients present in food are carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins and minerals. So these are the nutrients which are present in the food what you are taking. Our body needs all these nutrients along with roughage and water. You know children, for keeping our body healthy, what we need? We need all that food which are rich with carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins and minerals. Along with that, we need roughage and water also. So in this chart, we will come to know that in which food items vitamins, carbohydrates, minerals, roughage are present. So just see that chart. Along with that, open your book. First of all, we are going to study about carbohydrates. This is carbohydrates. Role of carbohydrates. Carbohydrates provide energy to the body. Sugar and starch are forms of carbohydrates. Carbohydrates give energy to our body, and sugar and starch. Starch means that rice water, that is the one of the starch, or boiled potato, in that also starch is present, are forms of the carbohydrates. Sources means by eating which food you can get carbohydrates in your body. What you all will take in the food that you can get carbohydrates, that is rice, wheat, maize, potatoes, bread, sugar, and so on. So in your food, if rice is there, you are taking rice, wheat, maize, potatoes, bread, sugar, and all, it means that you are taking carbohydrates, that is the one of the nutrient every day. Understood? Now next is proteins. So protein rich food is what? What is the role of protein? Protein help in the growth and repair of body. Protein help to your body to grow. It helps you in your growth, and it repairs our body. It repairs if you get an injury and all. So this, by eating this protein rich food, your body will get repair fast. Sources, by eating which food you can get protein, like pulses, you know children, dal, soya bean, milk, cheese, meat, fish, eggs, and so on. So if you want to get protein in your body, protein, namely nutrient, what you should take in your food? Pulses, soya beans, milk, cheese, meat, fish, eggs, etc. So these are the foods which are rich with proteins. Next is fats. What is the role of fat? What fats do in our body? Fats are stored in the body to provide energy for later use. Fat is stored in the body. It is stored in your body, and it gives energy for later use. Afterwards, if you want to use it, you can use. They also help in keeping the body warm, and fat keeps your body warm. Sources, butter, if you are taking butter, ghee, vegetables, oil, nuts, meat, fish, eggs, and so on. So these food items, if you are taking, so you are storing what? Fats in the body, and it provides energy to your body later. Okay, that is the food which are rich with fats. Now vitamins and minerals. What is the role of vitamins and minerals in your body? What these vitamins and minerals, nutrients do in your body? Our body needs vitamins and minerals in very small quantities. We require vitamins and minerals in very less quantity. You don't need it huge. Okay, they help our body to stay healthy and fight diseases. They help, vitamins and minerals help our body to stay healthy and fight with diseases also. Important vitamins are A, B, C, D, E, and K. Important minerals are iron, potassium, calcium, and iodine. Sources, what food will you take in your food items? What will you take so that you can get vitamins and minerals? Like vegetables, fruits, milk, eggs, seafood, and so on. So these all foods are rich with vitamins and minerals. Which food children? Vegetables, green vegetables, fruit, milk, eggs, seafood, and so on. And what is the work? What it does in our body? It keeps your body healthy and fight diseases. Clear? Now next is fibers and roughage. fiber helps food and waste. This is fiber and waste. Fiber helps food and waste to move easily through the digestive system. So it helps to move that waste easily through the digestive system. You have digestive system in your body that you have studied. So sources, fruits and vegetables, whole grains, breads and cereals, almonds, beans and so on. So in this food, like fruits and vegetables and whole grain breads, whole grains means like whole grain breads and cereals, like cereals, wheat, rice and all that, almonds, beans and so on, in this that fibers and roughage are present. And it have fiber has food and waste to move easily through the digestive system. It helps to waste to pass the waste through the digestive system. Next is water. What is the use of water in our body? Water helps all systems in our body to function properly. So water is most important in our body. It plays most important role. It helps in our body to function properly. It is a medium through which nutrients are carried to various parts of the body. And water is only the medium through which the various nutrients pass to our body. It carries various nutrients to all parts of our body. So it is playing an essential role, an important role in our body. That's why we say that every day you should take 8 glasses of water. Now, balanced diet. Our body needs all the nutrients in the right amount to be healthy and strong. So all the nutrients, what nutrients, children? Nutrients rich with protein, carbohydrates, fats, vitamins and minerals, fiber, roughage and water. That all are nutrients. So all nutrients, what food you are taking rich with these nutrients, it should be of right amount. Right amount means it should not be more in your body and it should not be less in your body. It should be in right amount. Okay, so we cannot get all the nutrients from any single food item. All the nutrients you are not getting from one item. It means that you have to take fish, meat, rice, soya bean, pearls, all the food items to take the nutrients. We cannot get, so our diet must include different food items and contain different nutrients. So our body, what it needs, it includes different food items and that contains different nutrients. So we require different food items, means you need milk also. Along with milk you should take potatoes also, wheat also, but everything should be at adequate amount. It should not be more and it should not be less also. It should be at right amount. Okay, so our diet must include different food items that contain different nutrients. A diet that include a variety of food containing the right amount of each nutrient is called the balanced diet. So what is balanced diet, children? A diet that includes a variety of food containing of right amount of each nutrients is called a balanced diet. So all the nutrients should be at right amount. That is only the balanced diet. Means nutrients you have to take, but that nutrients should be right amount. Very important, that food you are taking, what you are consuming, a diet that includes a variety of food, that different foods are there, it containing the right amount of each nutrients. There should be right amount of each nutrients. That is very important and that is only the balanced diet. A balanced diet also includes roughage and water. In that, water and roughage is also necessary. You know that what role plays water in our body, that it helps all systems in our body to function properly. So if you are not taking water, enough water, it means that your body will not function properly. If your function means work properly, if your body is like a machine, no. So if you, it will not work properly, means you will get sick, you won't be healthy.
Now components of balanced diet. A balanced diet is different for different people. For different people, that balanced diet is also different. This depends on their age and physical activity. It depends on the age of the person and their physical activity, that what type of work he is doing. Like someone is labor. So labor means they have to do lots of hard work. So they will consume more food. But someone is sitting in the office and consuming the food equivalent to labor. So it means that food will be more for him, more than enough, more than the right amount. Did you understand, children? So labor can take more food because he is doing more work. But if the person who is sitting in the office, if he is taking equal food like the labor, equivalent food like the labor, so it means that food is not right amount for the person who is sitting in the office, because he is not working, his physical activity is less. Clear, children? We divide foods into different groups so that we can easily choose different food items for a balanced diet. So that's why that foods are divided into different groups. So here the five main food groups are cereals and potatoes, fruits and vegetables, milk and milk products, pearls, meat, fish and eggs, fats, oils and sweets. So these all are divided into different groups. Now what is junk food? So you can choose these food items from these five food groups. Now junk food. What is junk food? Potatoes, chips, cold drink, chocolates, ice creams and noodles are junk food. If you are taking potato chips, cold drink, chocolates, ice creams and noodles, these all are called junk food. So you can get question, what is junk food? So you have to answer that. Potatoes, chips and cold drink, chocolates are, ice creams and noodles are junk food. Junk food is rich in salts. It has more salt, sugar and fats, but has very little protein. But it has less protein, vitamins and minerals. Eating junk food too often causes many health problems. So if you are taking every day this junk food, it can cause some health problems to you. As junk food contains very little amount of protein, it causes tiredness. Because junk food has very less protein, so it can cause tiredness. You can get tired fast. Junk food has very little vitamins and minerals. It has very less vitamins and minerals. And you know what is the role of vitamins and minerals? They help us to stay healthy and fight diseases. So junk food has very little role of vitamins and minerals. That has very less vitamins and minerals. The carbohydrates and sugar in junk food produce acid that can destroy tooth enamel. So in the junk food, what is present? The carbohydrates and sugar. And it can, food produces acids. It produces that carbohydrates and sugar to junk food produce acids that can destroy, that can spoil tooth enamel that is present in your teeth. Too many fatty and sugary foods can lead to obesity. If you are taking too many fatty food, sugary food, like junk food has fat and sugar, no? So if you are taking so much that will what happen? Eating junk food may increase the risk of having certain diseases such as diabetes and high blood pressure. So you will be fatty, you will be fat, and it will increase the diseases. Certain diseases such as which disease? Diabetes. Because diabetes, how it causes? Due to sugar. Okay. So if you are taking more sugar, so that disease, diabetes and high blood pressure can be caused. So this is in the lesson. Remaining we will study in the next video. Thank you, children.